We'll get into, should we get in? Well, let's do the Sarah news first, shall we? Because this is amazing. If this doesn't deserve this, I don't know what does. Yeah, big ABC news headline. Ready? Sarah Palin uses PAC to buy her own book. Political Action Committee paid more than $60,000 for copies of Going Rogue in late 2009. Yeah, you know why that would be if ABC had followed this woman and had watched what she was doing. It would make sense, and I would hope that her PAC would have bought them. She offered her book as a fundraiser at a certain point. You all remember that before it came out. A lot of you donated $100 to her PAC, and you got a signed copy of Going Rogue. The publisher did not donate those. They can't. They weren't free. You have to buy them. Here's the deal. As a writer, like for me with my books, I get books, and bookstores get books at 50% of the cover price, by the way. All right? So what you're paying in the store, that extra 50% is a piece going to the author and the piece going, of course, to the publisher. And whatever, this is why bookstores can say, oh, 40% off, because they're still making a 10% profit. Okay? So when you can buy your own book for half the cover price, and you can do whatever you want with it, for the most part. Yeah. And that every author who has something going on does that. Now, I've never had to do a fundraiser. When my books have come out, I've sent some to my supporters and helpers, and you buy them yourself. Should they announce? This is so, not only is it irrelevant, everybody does it. Joe Lieberman did it. I guarantee you, I have to look back and see if there was any fundraising on the Bill Clinton and Sarah and the Hillary Clinton books. I bet you they did it. Well, yeah, they bought thousands for this purpose, which means thousands of you donated, and you got a free copy, quote unquote free. Okay. It was $63,000 for books for fundraising donor fulfillment. Money went to HarperCollins, who's her publisher. And also her committee paid her publisher $20,000 for what appears to have been the cost of sending her a photographer and another aide along on the book tour. Absolutely. Cause you know, it's going to happen. There's going to be a paperback. That book tour, I would hope, was in and of itself, we know, was an event. We know that book tour sent a huge message. This isn't just about selling 2 million books in 2 weeks. The books are still selling. It was the people putting up tents in snowstorms so that they could be in the right place in line. I'm going to guess that I would hope, would be part of the paperback updated version. It's a remarkable event. It still is. Yeah, so the ABC News headline is effectively castigating Sarah Palin for knowing what she's doing and for being organized. It's ridiculous. Yeah, so you look at the headline, it's like, oh my gosh, she's cheating the bestseller lists with cheating and buying the books herself. Not quite. Not quite. In the very, in the next to last paragraph of the ABC breaking news story, Palin would not be the first politician to use a PAC to underwrite the purchase of a memoir. The FEC has heard a number of cases on the question whether it's appropriate. Bottom line is, it is appropriate. So they still infer, like, this might be wrong. No, it's not wrong. Yeah. The fact is, and they notice, well, you know, they're complex rules because Palin's neither a candidate nor is she a sitting member of Congress. But we're trying to pull as much out of our ass as we can to try to make it look like she might have no ethics or something, because we're running out of depends and we can't stand what's going to go on here, because we'll be out in the cold if she ever becomes president. What? Oh, I added that last part. Could you tell? I don't know. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, Joe Lieberman did it. Others have done it. First of all, there's two things. One, when you put Sarah Palin's name in a headline, just I'm letting you know, your traffic skyrockets. So they're using her, but they don't want to use her to make her look good. So they want to use her to get traffic. And then, of course, to try, because the percentages here also, about 90% of people only read the headlines to stories, not only on the internet, but of course in newspapers as well. About another, a few more percent then read the first paragraph only. And maybe 3% of people read the entire stories. Now, I know this. Editors know it. Writers know it. That's why the relevant stuff that contradicts their own material ends up at the end of an article. Don't be dragged around like that. That's effectively, if you hear a little click, click sound, that's the ring being put in your nose. It's like, ow! Don't let that happen to you. You might agree with, if you're an Obama zombie, with what they're trying to do to her. But they're not just doing it on Sarah Palin. Yeah, I think you might want to know who's doing what to whom. Just a little something. On this weekend at the Tea Party convention, I'll let you know, she has issued a Facebook on why she is speaking there after all of the attempts to demonize the Tea Party convention. Look, there are lots, as I've mentioned before, I don't have a horse in this race. I like what all of you, as a former leftist organizer, I am thrilled to see conservatives organizing in any capacity. It's imperative. It's imperative to get money. Look, you being out there in the public has encouraged certain people to run, that they feel like they're not alone. You know how that's important for you to not feel like you're alone. It's important also for politicians feel like they're not alone. It actually was a USA Today op-ed and pitched through the Facebook page of Sarah Palin. And I like her approach. Look, again, there are many different approaches to the Tea Party thing. In this instance, and I've noted also, what is suddenly the problem conservatives have with profit? If somebody's going to set up something and is going to make a profit, more power to them. If you're going to have the money and participate, great. If you don't want to do it, then don't. She has this piece. It's titled, Why I'm Speaking at the Tea Party Convention. She says, from the town halls last summer to the protests and marches in the fall to the game-changing recent elections, it has been inspiring to see real people, not politicos or inside the Beltway professionals, speak out for common sense conservative politics and policies and values. She said, legitimate disagreements take place about tone and tactics. That's okay, because this movement is about bigger things than politics or organizers. That's exactly it. Look, if you disagree with whomever is setting up the Nashville thing, there are tea parties in every city with different personalities, different flavors, different dynamics. As there's something for everybody, and you've managed as being cats being organized to come together when necessary. That's imperative. This is larger than even very often who gets credit. She goes on later, their vision is what drew me to the Tea Party movement. She says, recently some have tried to portray the movement as a commercial endeavor rather than the grassroots uprising that it is. Look, let me just tell you. You can have a grassroots uprising and make money. Well, the left tells its activists, as a very few people at the top get filthy rich, they romanticize going bankrupt and being a victim. The thing that separates out you conservatives, and even if you're a classical liberal, is the fact that you know you can be successful and help this country and that you do not need to become a victim in the process. Look, there's a reason why I do not own a home in my 40s, because I lost almost everything when I was an activist on the left and was encouraged to spend all my money. In part, it's because it reinforces the victim mentality and then you become even more dependent on their system. Okay? I'm still paying that price and trying to rebuild what someone of my sort would have had in her 40s, because I bought that crap. I bought it, hook, line, and sinker. Making up for it now in as many ways as I can. But all the more reason why I do not let that lie about grassroots, meaning that you have to be unsuccessful or a victim. She says, this weekend it's Nashville, but in March I'll head to Searchlight, Nevada for the kickoff rally at the Tea Party Express 3. In April, she'll be in Boston for a Tea Party gathering there. I love you guys. I never knew that I could love you guys in Massachusetts. I'm so excited, being Scots-Irish and everything, and just the importance of Massachusetts. I love you guys. Thanks for like, I'm not patronizing you about doing the right thing. It's just so heartening. And so she's going to be in a few places, of course. She's an excellent, this is an excellent op-ed piece explaining loyalty, the nature of a grassroots effort. And I'll tell you again, look, this is one effort of dozens. And whoever came up with it, it was a great idea. And if they want to make a profit, that's up to them.